Hey guys, it's Emily Lane with MP Guide. I'm the administrator here. If you haven't seen me before, hi, it's nice to meet you. I'm glad you're here in our group. We're approaching 5,000 members and that is amazing. Today I want to talk about a very common question that's posted is how do I find a preceptor? It's such a hard thing to do, and it was hard even before COVID, but now it's even more hard. So a lot of my premises, advices, and tips are going to be based on a non-COVID environment because a lot of the rules have kind of changed for now about whether places are really even taking students. So one of my first suggestions is if you're in a cohort and you have a Facebook group or a discussion board or anything like that, asking students in your area who they've used before, because they're going to be more familiar with your area. And then the preceptor themselves are gonna be familiar with your school. That can be very helpful. So asking, other people in your class who they've used if they're in your region. That's helpful. One of the other big things I'll say is a lot of university hospitals or large teaching hospitals are contracted with certain schools. So before you're picking what school you're going into, maybe look into that because state schools are more likely to be contracted with a local teaching hospital. So you'll have a better chance of getting preceptors if you go to a school like that. So I went to Clemson University. It's a state school in South Carolina. We have a contract with one of the biggest hospital systems in the state. And I did not have very much trouble getting placed with a preceptor because we had that collaboration. So that's something you really want to consider when you're applying to schools is, Simmons is a great university and it's great for distance learning, but they're not going to have the same relationships with a local state hospital or a teaching hospital that say my state school did. I'm not saying there's any difference in the education. I'm just saying it's easier to get preceptors if the college already has a contract with a hospital. So that's something to ask when you're applying to a school and looking to schools. Do you have any standing contracts that guarantee me placement? Because mine did, and I did not have to sit out. I did have to try to find my own preceptor. If it didn't work out, they placed you with somebody, and it was very convenient and very helpful. So ask that question of schools before applying to them. The next thing is, of course, every school is supposed to help you find one at this point due to the accreditation rules out there. It's not held up. It's not going to be held up. And even if you complain, there's not much that can actually be done about it. As long as they give you a list of preceptors that have been previously used by students, they've covered themselves. Even if none of those preceptors agree to take you, they've still kind of done their due diligence is the way they kind of get around it. So it's hard to really kind of enforce that rule, considering there are so many students, so many schools, and only so many preceptors. Another way to go around it is not all large hospital systems are contracted with the university already. Most of these places have something called an education department. So there's another hospital in the next county over, it's called regional, and they are not contracted with any specific university, but you have to go to their education department to get a preceptor. You can't call the individual clinics and ask them, hey, is so-and-so available to take on a student? It doesn't work that way. You have to apply to the education department, and tell them like your class, your school, how many hours you need, do you need an ND, NP, PA, etc. And then they have a pool or a list of clinicians that will serve as preceptors and you can get placed. Those typically get booked up 1 to 2 years in advance. So if you find a university or find a hospital, teaching hospital, hospital system, anything like that, it's not contracted exclusively with a specific college already, see if they have an education department that has a service like that. Because again, the hospital in the next county over from me has a service like that, but I can't cold call the clinics. They will tell me they can't place me. I have to contact the education department. Sometimes this may be why you're getting a bunch of no's, is because they are not allowed to place you because they have that system in place. It's to avoid 6 million phone calls to their office manager, and it's also to help streamline the process, because a lot of times you have to go through the hospital system to do things like paperwork, HIPAA compliance things, training on their EMR, signing a whole bunch of stuff to say that you'll not, sell their information or leak information, etc. So it streamlines the process. So it's really just a convenience thing for that hospital system. So if you're getting a bunch of no's, try to do some digging around and see if there's an education department at that university. They usually handle the medical residents too, okay? So if you find something on the website that talks about like the medical residence department, they also can help NPs find placement. Again, do that 1 to 2 years out. So go ahead and already have a list of everything you wanna do. Your last option is always privately owned clinics. There's a couple of those in my area as well that I actually contacted, but was told, you know, absolutely we take students 1 to 2 years in advance. So that's another thing, is to look at all the privately owned ones that are not related to a hospital system. But again, if it's a hospital system, they usually have an education department or a freestanding contract with a specific hospital or specific university. So my big takeaways is, when you're applying for schools, find out if it's a state school, they should have a contract with a local hospital. That's very convenient and helpful. If you are not associated with like a state university, say something online like Simmons or Chamberlain, call around to the different hospitals and see if they have a contract. If every single major hospital system in your area and most of the clinics are already pre-contracted, really consider that before you go to NP school, or picking an NP school, okay? Because I don't want you to be stuck with absolutely no way to get in to with a preceptor. So these are some of the things you need to research before you even start, to make sure that you're not stuck. A lot of these people posting probably didn't know these things and didn't do this research before they applied or started, and didn't realize how difficult it was going to be. I had no idea how hard it was going to be when I started. So these are just some things I've learned during my grad school experience and over the past few years of trying to help people find preceptors. The hardest things to get into are women's and pediatrics, so go ahead and get those done now, 1 to 2 years in advance. I think that's everything I wanted to talk about with clinicals today, and just some tips and tricks to hopefully help you guys find somebody. If you have any questions or need any clarification on anything I said today, please go ahead and post a comment below and I'll get back to you and answer those questions. If you found this information useful, give me a thumbs up, and I hope you guys have a great rest of your day. Bye.